This is VOA News. I'm Joe Ramsey. Huge plumes of smoke, sounds of firing, arms and blasts were seen over the Gaza skyline close to the border area on Saturday. Residents said Israeli troops had been clashing with Hamas gunmen all night in and around Gaza City. Hamas is a U.S.-designated terrorist group. Arab and Islamic leaders on Saturday met in the Saudi capital Riyadh, blasting the Israeli operation and its heavy toll on Palestinian civilians and infrastructure. Edward Uranian reports for VOA from Cairo.
Iranian President Ibrahim Raisi, whose visit to Saudi Arabia for Saturday's summit was the first by an Iranian president in more than a decade, claimed the Israeli military operation in Gaza was the worst crime witnessed in human history. Raisi went on to urge Arab and Islamic states to designate the Israeli army a terrorist group and to impose a boycott on Israel, including oil and other goods. Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, using a more measured tone, called for an immediate ceasefire in Gaza. Edward Uranian for VOA News, Cairo.
Supporters of the Palestinians have marched peacefully through central London as right-wing counter-protesters clashed with police after a week of angry debate over whether to permit the demonstration on a day when Britain honored its war dead. Tensions have been fueled by Home Secretary Suala Braverman's comments earlier this week in which she characterized pro-Palestinian demonstrators as hate marches and called for Saturday's event to be blocked out of respect for Armistice Day. The march was apparently the largest in London since the start of the conflict. This is VOA News. The UN Refugee Agency and Sudanese doctors say fighters from a paramilitary force and their allied Arab militias rampaged through a town in the war-ravaged region of Darfur, reportedly killing more than 800 people. The days-long attack in West Darfur province came after the paramilitary rapid support forces took over a military base there on November 4th. The head of the Sudanese Doctors Union in West Darfur says the RSF and their allied Arab militias rampaged through the town, killing non-Arabs inside their homes and torching shelters housing displaced people. On the one-year anniversary of the liberation of Kherson from Russian forces, Ukrainians hold on to the hope amid constant shelling. AP correspondent Karen Chamas reports.
A group of Ukrainians gather outside the regional state administration building in Kherson. Drinking champagne, they celebrate a year since the city was retaken from the Russians by Ukrainian forces. However, residents have grown accustomed to hearing outgoing fire from the left bank of the Dnieper River, and life has not yet gone back to normal. The anniversary is a bittersweet occasion, as Ukraine's counteroffensive is not making the spectacular gains they had hoped for. Instead, both sides are locked in a stalemated battle of attrition. I'm Karen Chamas.
Reports from Myanmar say one of the military's government's jet fighters has crashed in a combat zone in the eastern state of Kaya. An officer in Myanmar's military confirmed one of its aircraft crashed somewhere in Kaya, but said he didn't know whether it was shot down or crashed due to technical failure. No warplanes are known to have been shot down previously by resistance forces since the army seized power in 2021 from the elected government of Aung San Suu Kyi. Danish drug maker Novo Nordisk says the heart protective benefits of its wildly popular obesity treatment are due to more than just weight loss. Reuters correspondent Angela Johnston reports.
Novo had released early data in August, which showed Wegovy reduced incidence of heart attack, stroke, or death from heart disease by 20%. It's been shown to help patients lose an average of 15% of their weight. Now, the full results from the drug maker's SELECT trial are out, and researchers say they show Wegovy reduced the risk of a non-fatal heart attack by 28% and heart-related death by 15% compared to a placebo. Novo said the cardiovascular benefits appeared before patients started losing weight, which could mean heart protection was not purely due to weight loss.
Reuters correspondent Angela Johnston. I'm Joe Ramsey.
We'll be right back. Thank you for watching. Can you do me a favor? Please leave a comment in the comment section below. That would really help. Thank you, and see you again soon.